We are the members of Project Group 2nd of Kunjali Marakar School of Marine Engineering. Our project topic is Steerable Kort Nozzle Propeller. Our project guide is Professor Roy B. Paul. He is our course coordinator also. Our project in charge is Professor Dr. Sasi Kumar. Our batch members are Joseph Johnny, Chinadev G.K., myself Deven Pandey, Jijo Jacob Paul, Jay Mohan D. and Dennis Prakash. Our project is based on the idea of putting shroud around the propeller. This propeller is known as ducted propeller. These propellers are of two types, depending upon their size. If the aerofoil pressure, high pressure is outwards, then it is known as de-accelerating type. If it is inward, then it is known as accelerating type. This propeller is the example of accelerating type. This idea was invented by Steerable Kort Nozzle in 1934. By these ducted propellers, we can increase the thrust. By that, the efficiency will increase. So it is very useful to use in tugs and trawlers and other small boats. Depending upon the arrangement of the steering, it is further divided in two types. One is steerable, other is fixed. In fixed types, the nozzle will not move. But our is steerable type. In this, this nozzle will move. So if we want to turn the ship, accordingly we turn the nozzle and the ship will be turning. So it has the added advantage of maneuverability with the propulsion. In this, we have used a DC motor which will turn the nozzle and we will get the movement of the ship.
1934, Ludwig Kort proposed a theory that putting a shroud around a propeller increases the propeller efficiency and the thrust as well. And here you can see there is a shroud or a nozzle which is wrapped around this propeller. Let's see how this stuff works. And you consider an ordinary propeller. When it turns, there will be at the trailing edge, that means the front side, there will be more water pressure than the leading edge. In ordinary propeller, there's a chance of water, that means water escape from propeller blade tip to the lower pressure side, thus by reducing the efficiency of the propeller. But while using this kind of propellers, it prevents such efficiency loss and thus produces more thrust.
So I'll be explaining about the manufacturing and working of this model. So first, we had to make a propeller, and it was a very reducible size of than the conventional type. And we went to a boat workshop nearby Cochin, and we made a sand casting model of propeller with gunmetal. And the major challenge for us was the making of this Kort nozzle, because the nozzle it had a patented dimensions and all from, because it's a German company. So we went to Cochin Port Trust, we had a marine drawing of the nozzle. We made an AutoCAD design of this nozzle, and the first thing we did was we made a cast iron frame. We welded the frame according to the dimensions, and to that frame we properly cut the GI sheets and we welded that sheets onto the frame. And we had certain deformities on this, but we managed by putting polymer putties inside that. And we gave a final finishing coat of it. And you can see it's an accelerating type according to the profile. And you know, this nozzle is coupled to a geared DC motor because we need to take the load of the nozzle. And we designed an electronic circuit of proper angle and all, or triangle and all. And it is driven by DC motor with control switches over it. And the shafting of this is made by is made in mild steel with 75 centimeter in length to 20 mm diameter, and the shaft is tapered as of the normal conventional type, and it is bolted at the end. The speed, I mean, this shaft is coupled to an induction motor, a single phase induction motor, and to reduce the vibrations and all, we had to put rubber chocks on the mountings of the motor, and the regulator speed is regulated by using high resistance regulator, which is mounted on the control panel.
Hi, and welcome to Marine Biz TV. You're watching the world's first global maritime TV channel.
Sorry, I had problems at the port state control with my ship.
With the GL classified ship?
We are the students of KMSME School of Marine Engineering of last semester batch, and we have done a project on the model construction of a bulk carrier. Our team includes of 6 members, namely Cadet Nikhil Ramachandran, then next is Srijit Manohar, then myself Madheshwar Gupta, then Krishna Prasad J. Menon and Muhammad Harsus Jalil, and the last but not the least is Malik Muhammad Fahad. So, our sincere thanks to our project guide, that is Mr. K. Vidyadharan sir and Professor Dr. Sasi Kumar sir, for their able guidance and support which has given during the construction of our project ship. Now, to start with its definition, a bulk carrier is a merchant vessel which is basically designed to carry a cargo in bulk, and that is iron ore, coal, cement, etc. Now, this bulk carrier is classified into so many parts, like based on their sizes, and that is CV size, then cap size, Panamax, Handy Max, and Handy size. And this one is the model of Handy Max size of length 1.5 meter and maximum beam is 0.25 meter and depth is 0.15 meter. Now, the main aim of our project is to help the students of marine engineering and those students who are going to make their career at sea in getting acquainted with all the constructional details of various parts of their ships. And because as we know that our workplace is going to be the ship, so we must have a sound knowledge of all the constructional details which will help in the smooth and efficient operation of a ship. Now, the next in chain, it also establishes to make effective communication system on board the ship, because if someone asks to bring something from poop deck and we don't know poop deck and all, then it will be very difficult to have the effective communication system. So basic purpose is also the same thing. Now we will describe the various parts of this all ships. To understand the various parts of the ships, we can subdivide this into two parts, that is one after arrangement and one fore arrangement. So after arrangement basically consists of engine room, superstructure, funnel, then if enclosed liveboat launching is there, then at the back it will be there. A rudder will be for a steering purpose and propeller will be there. Now At the same time, we can divide that thing four part also. That will be the bulbous bow, which will help to reduce the wave which is coming while ship is moving. So, and the next is forecastle arrangement, where will be deck fittings and all will be there, just to lower the anchor and heaving up. And various mooring arrangements will be there to just put the ships alongside the quay. And after there, foremast will be there and aftermast will be there. And at the deck structure will be super at this deck, there will be hatch covers and bulwarks will be there just to prevent the man overboard. Now we will describe how these ships we have made. First, we have drawn the lines, plans and body plan. With the help of that one, we have cut the paper cutting of frame. And that paper cutting we have put after laying down the keel, we have put at regular intervals that frames, and in between that we have put foam so that to make the structure rigid and strong. And after that, side framings we have put just to give the particular shapes. And wherever curve is there we have used basswood so that we can bend very easily. And here all these parts where bent is not required, there we have used plywood. Then superstructure also we have made with the help of plywood itself.
We have built here a middle section, cross section of a bulk area. We show some part here how we build it. We build with galvanized sheet, fiber glasses and plywood. We have used tank top we have made. This is the tank top. This is bottom keep plate. This is longitudinal bottom and this is tank top longitudinal. Now this, the shell plating we have made with galvanized sheet. To support this, to make it rigid and stiff, we have used a web frame. We can see inside. This is hatch combing and this is your hatch cover that shown on the ship here. Then this is the manhole. This is the solid floor with a continuous bracket. We have made this a top deck plate like a camber, so little raised above, and we have made a thumbnail that is little inside a shell plating. This is overall view of a middle section, cross section of a bulk area.
I do know that sailing full time is as good a religion as there is.
Now one day it so happened that we were almost caught in a cyclone. 50 degree angle, you can imagine, you know. You cannot stand. I was also holding on to the railing and just hanging.
My wife is working, she's a senior leader in Delhi University. So during summer time, she along with the kids used to join me on board. So the gap between, the separation time between us was not much.
We are the final year students. We are of the fourth batch. We have constructed a model of Scotch Boiler here. Our project coordinator is Professor Dr. Shashi Kumar sir, and project guide is Professor Venu sir. We in this batch are 5 members, starting from Ranjit VK, Praveen P, Ranjit R, Shabri Shashi Chandran, and Rohit R. Ours is a model of Scotch Boiler. Scotch Boiler is used has a variety of purpose in ship. It is designed to create steam in the ship. It has a lot of uses. There are many type of boilers here, out of which the Scotch Boiler is very simple and of robust construction.
Here is a model of Scotch Boiler we have made, and we have made it to the reduced size of 1/4 to the original boiler. Here the main parts here is the furnace through which the flue gases from the furnace comes, and it passes through the combustion chamber and goes to the other end through the smoke tubes. And we have provided the stay tubes for giving it support and strength. And we have painted in different colors to distinguish them. And the other parts is the boiler mountings. Here it is a safety valve together with the air vent, and it's the steam stop valve. And here are the scum valves and the blowdown valves. And the other end we can see the smoke tube and the boiler uptake. And those are the furnaces.
Here at Kunjali Marakkar School of Marine Engineering of Cochin University, we conduct 4-year BTEC Marine Engineering program. Our cadets, on satisfactory completion of the course and passing out the examination, will be sailing over the high seas of various shipping companies of the world. They are going to work as marine engineers, which means they will be operating and maintaining machineries and equipments on board ships. For doing this satisfactorily, they need to have proper hands-on training. To enable them acquire the necessary competencies for running the ship, they are given exposure in the shipping campus, here in the campus itself, also in the simulation training and the project work. The project work and seminars are conducted during the final semester here at Kunjali Marakkar School of Marine Engineering to give them practical exposure to designing and fabrication of some of the components of the ship. To guide them as well as to instruct them in the satisfactory completion of project work, we have course in charge, Professor N.G. Nair, and the coordinator or the professor, Dr. Shashi Kumar. They have direct access to the students in their individual capacity to ensure that they do a satisfactory job in the seminar as well as in the completion of the project work. They also do, as I said, mentioned earlier, they undergo one entire semester in the shipping campus to get hands-on experience in the operation and maintenance of machineries.
These projects demonstrate how young talents can excel in executing innovative projects based on theories they studied in the confines of their classrooms. What we have seen here is a clear manifestation of innovative ideas, teamwork and commitment, and above all, an enduring spirit scaling heights.